Jaunais Eiropas ekonomiskās zonas un Norvēģijas finansējuma periods izcili saskana ar sarunu festivālu lampu. Turpmākajos gados Norvēģija, Islanda, Lihtenšteina Latvijai ieguldīs apmēram 100 miljonus eiro. Šī gada festivāla tēma ir drosme. Un šo valstu pamata ideja, kāpēc novirzīt finansējumu, ir drosmīgas pārmaiņas. Bet, lai drosmīgas pārmaiņas veiktu, sākumā ir jādiskutē, jāspriež un jāizdara secinājumi un jāuzstāda mērķi. To mēs darīsim divas dienas šeit, sarunu festivāla lampu. Aiziet!
These projects are in many, many sectors, in the justice sector, in environment, in economic and social development, innovation, green innovation, regional development, and also geographic areas in Latvia, where we will have cooperation projects between Norway and Latvia. And as ambassador of Norway to Latvia, this is a fantastic tool for enhancing the cooperation between our two countries.
The Norway grants in Latvia, their aim is really to develop Latvian businesses. The overarching aim is the social and economic disparities should be mitigated, but what really this is about in Latvia is developing Latvian businesses, enhance their degree of innovation. At the same time, create green results for most of the projects.
Mums paredzēts uzbūvēt jaunu mācību centru Olēnē, kā arī cietumu paraugu korpusus, jo mēs plānojam ne tikai pilnveidot vai pilnīgi no jauna uzlabot mācību sistēmu tieši personālam, ieguldīties tajā. Daudz ko kopēsim arī no Norvēģiem, un tai skaitā arī tādu jauninājumu cietumu sistēmā, kā mācību vai prakses cietumi, un Olēnes cietums būs viens no tiem.
The whole idea of Lampa, I think it's really good. There are many people interested in what I do, in what we do in prison, what's happening inside a prison. It's interesting to hear the questions from the audience, to talk with people afterwards, because you open people's minds. They get the chance to think in a different way, with some insight from people who know what they're talking about.
Norway and Latvia are very different in many ways. The size of the country and the landscape, and in many senses also part of our cultures. But I think we understand that our countries are more than just the capital and maybe the two, three largest cities. If we just take those places and develop those, you are left with not what you think of when you think of your home country. So, to support the areas where the primary industries are made, where the folklore was made, the songs that we had when we grew up, to ensure that people live there, that people actually make use of the nature of the resources, that they don't leave these traditions behind. I think that's important. It's important for our national psyche.